time to tune in. Now the another sports center. It's a movement.
All right, so we got some player profiles here for you guys that we're going to take and discuss here today. Let's go ahead. Let's kick it off with Sebastian Joseph Day of the Los Angeles Rams. Take it away, Adrian.
Look, man, he's probably not a household name to people who are not Rams fans or to so-called Rams fans who have not really watched the team in the past 4 years. Also, if you're calling yourself a Rams fan and you haven't watched the team in the last 4 years, I don't know what you're doing with your life, because I've been a Rams fan for over 20 years, and these last four years outside of the Super Bowl year are easily the best years of my fandom ever. So if you're just missing out on those, I don't know what you're doing. But Sebastian Joseph Day, quiet, I believe, fourth round pick for us about 3 years ago, plays along the defensive line, super charismatic guy, super hard worker. You see him getting the snaps, and of course you're not going to, it's kind of hard to make a name for yourself on the Rams defensive line when you're sitting next to Aaron Donald, who's always going to get the headlines. Also, you know, we had Michael Brockers on there before we traded him away to the Lions, and say what you want to say about Michael Brockers. That's another name along that line. And then, you know, during the Super Bowl year, the Super Bowl run, we added Ndamukong Suh, another big name that's just taken away credit. And then we had A'shaun Robinson that we signed last year that will be back with the team this year, who is another not huge, huge name, but he's a notable name along this defensive front. So Sebastian Joseph Day, number 69, hasn't got a lot of love, but he's a super, super positive guy, super fun follow on Twitter. If you haven't seen him, he's got this Good Eat show, just a live wire, but his work ethic is tremendous. The kid is an absolute monster, and I'm banking on it this year, especially where, you know, we're talking about getting ready to play for some money. He's a homegrown product for LA, and I think he's going to make his case that for staying in LA, for getting the bag and being Aaron Donald's right-hand man, being the number two on that line, the way that we really wanted Michael Brockers to be. But I think he's just a young, fast, athletic freak. And I think he's going to give offensive lines throughout the league big fits this year. So I'm expecting big things from Sebastian Joseph Day.
He a big guy, man. He's 6'4", man. He ain't little.
No, brother did not miss a meal. You know, he's been out there eating all that food out in California. He's been eating all your down south stuff. This is not a tiny guy. Offensive lines, watch out, especially if you don't have an offensive line. Seattle, I'm looking at you. We coming to see y'all.
Oh,
I think he'll follow the Michael Brockers mold, man, playing next to arguably one of the greatest defensive players, defensive tackles in NFL history, Aaron Donald, who's made Pro Bowls, first team All Pros, defensive end. Like, dude's an absolute beast. So he definitely takes up attention where these guys can thrive. Michael Brockers, I wanted the Broncos to sign because he's big. We need that kind of body, but, you know, we got outbid, obviously. But I think Sebastian Joseph Day, he's had solid stats. I mean, playing with those two guys has had, as a D tackle, over 40 tackles each year as a backup, as a third guy in that rotation, third to fourth guy. So I think he has a great opportunity, but I have a hard time believing. I mean, I don't know. The Rams just set the cap. They hit the clear cap button every single year, so they have all his money that comes out of nowhere. But I think he'll play well and probably end up somewhere else like Michael Brockers did, unless they can find a way to sign him before he had, like, this crazy breakout, you know?
Yeah, I agree with you, man. And that's part of the heartbreak of being a Rams fan, and man, is a lot of our homegrown talent, we don't get to keep. We don't get to re-sign. They make it to that first contract, and they're out of here. And that's because the Rams, these last 4 years under Sean McVay and Les Snead, have made big splash moves in free agency, you know, giving away big draft hauls to bring in players like Jalen Ramsey and, you know, to take shots at Ndamukong Suh. And yeah, we brought in Leonard Floyd and ultimately ended up re-signing Leonard Floyd, signed Jalen Ramsey. There was a lot of fans in Jacksonville, like on Twitter during his contract year, that were just like, haha, the Rams gave us two first round picks, and ultimately they're not going to be able to sign this guy. There's no way that Jalen stays in there. And then when we got the deal done, on top of being able to extend Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods, and then, like I said, this offseason we have extended Leonard Floyd, We've got Matt Stafford now in the building. Like, the Rams have all of these huge contracts. It is very, very hard to keep our, you know, our homegrown talent, or even like talent that we've acquired from other places that we've kind of helped develop, like a Darius Williams, who was cut from the Baltimore Ravens, but had a breakout season last year. And I expect him to continue to flourish this year, but I don't know if we end up re-signing Darius Williams, hence the Robert Rochelle pick this year, because I think they're banking that he's going to go somewhere and get paid. John Johnson III, another guy that I loved, especially during our Super Bowl run. You guys might remember him. He was the guy that intercepted Drew Brees in the overtime that gave the Rams a chance to kick their way into the Super Bowl, regardless of how you feel the calls in that game went. He's a big guy. He was also the defensive signal caller. That is going to be a huge gap for the Rams this year on defense, just his actual leadership and his presence there. He's going to make a big impact up there in Cleveland and definitely help bolster that secondary and provide the leadership and the discipline and the direction that they need to truly become a great defense. And I miss that guy. I wish we could have signed him. I love who we have back there and our young guys, Taylor Rapp, Jordan Fuller, Terrell Burgess, who I think is also going to be a monster back there. But yeah, man, you want to keep all your guys. And unfortunately, this is a league. It's a business. You can't keep everybody. Mm-hmm. If you could, we'd have super teams like the Yankees, right? I mean, don't get me wrong. I know the Yankees just got bounced, but I'm just saying we could just buy championships. And unfortunately, that's not the way it's done in the league.
Time to tune in. Now another Sports Center. It's a movement.